Welcome to the Gay Catholic Hour, a program of news, entertainment, healing, and affirmation brought to you by Dignity New York, an organization serving marginalized Catholics since 1972.
The women and men of Dignity want you to feel right at home, no matter what your sexual orientation, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgendered, or straight.
We are all God's children.
Welcome to the Gay Catholic Hour. I'm Chris Capiello. I am live on Fifth Avenue for the 1999 New York Lesbian and Gay Pride Parade. We've got the Harlettes behind me right now. You've been looking at some sights and sounds of the parade this year, and we've got a lot more coming up in this show. We'll have some footage from our Pride Mass last night at St. Mary the Virgin, and lots of other Pride events. Dignity's Witness in front of the cathedral, and some more fun shots of the parade. The mercury is rising here today, and it isn't just because of the dykes on bikes or the go-go boys on the floats. It is hot. So stay tuned, and we'll have lots more fun footage.
By asserting themselves, controlled, boxed in, or possessed as our own, able only to be shared, and in so being, to recreate the world. Dunamis, the power with which Jesus healed and drew people to him, is God's power, a relational power released only in the making of right relation, justice, righteousness. To be in Christ is to share this power of God which drives towards justice. The moral act of love between people, black and white, Jew and Christian, rich and poor. To be with Christ is necessarily to live dangerously, because changing the world is a turbulent process, and because people who take seriously their embodiment of God's power often get hurt. To be in Christ is to love with passion, which involves our willingness to suffer or bear the power of God in our choices and actions, to insist that God's power moving among us in the world affects love in relation, justice in society, food for the hungry, liberation for the oppressed. To be with Christ is to live with our feet on the ground of ambiguity and confusion every day, and to know that our decisions make a difference in our homes with family and in our most intimate relationships, in our jobs, in the way we spend money, in the ways we eat, in the priorities we establish in our lives, in our investments, in our commitment. Our lives count. And where we act in love, that is, an ends of being related deeply to others, we are in Christ.
Bisexual, transgendered, have experienced exclusion, rejection, alienation, and hopelessness. But we have heard the voice of God say,
I will make of the outcast a strong nation.
Many of us, differently abled, hearing impaired, and heterosexual with so-called different or unacceptable relationships or family, have experienced the inaccessibility and inhospitality of many churches, synagogues, and temples. But we have heard the voice of God say,
I will make of the outcast a strong nation.
I'm here with my good friend and steering committee member, Brendan Fay, who has organized today's witness in front of the cathedral. Now, Brendan, I understand this was a hard-won court battle that got us here.
Yes, it was, Chris, and happy Pride Day to you.
Happy Pride Day
to
you.
And to all our listeners who are celebrating Pride, I'm sure. And, this was a hard-won battle for dignity, but a very significant one. In the early 80s, Dignity, along with other groups, struggled to have a presence here on the cathedral. And this wound up in court, Dignity versus the Catholic War Veterans, and Dignity was granted the legal right to have a presence here just as much as the Catholic War Veterans and other anti-gay and lesbian groups who continue to come here year after year. So we have been here year after year for a half an hour, 25 members witnessing to our gay and lesbian Catholic presence here on the steps of the cathedral.
And there's a wonderful synergy that happens as we stand here in the pen with the parade going by, because people assume that we are an anti-gay group.
That's right, yeah.
Initially. And when they realize that we're Dignity, I think there's
a wonderful energy. They throw kisses, they wave, and they realize the significance of signs and a gay, lesbian, Catholic presence in front of the cathedral. And God knows the cathedral and the police and other forces have done their best to render us invisible. And so this is very, very significant.
In fact, the Cardinal himself is generally sitting out here for most other parades that do go up or down Fifth
Avenue.
That's
right, yes. Every other celebration in the city, you're absolutely right.
That's right. So until he is able to sit here and bear witness for us, we'll be here, I think.
Well, here we are back in the studio, and with me tonight is the lovely and talented Will Berger, our roving reporter, who has graciously roved into the studio to be with us tonight. Well, after all those images of gay pride, it's hard to believe what a busy month it's been since gay pride.
Absolutely, and the hottest month in New York's history.
In fact,
Chris and I are not wearing anything from the waist down tonight.
That's right.
But it would have been hot in any case because of all the news that's going on since gay pride. First and foremost, I think we need to speak about a story that's been very important to all progressive Catholics, about the Nugent Gramick story.
Absolutely.
Sister Janine Gramick, in case you don't know, this has been in the New York Times and all over the place. Sister Janine Gramick and Father Robert Nugent are a nun and a priest, respectively, who have ministered to the lesbian community for over 25 years, I have here. And they were ordered by the Vatican's Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. That's the new name for the Grand Inquisitor.
The SS.
Yes, that's Cardinal Ratzinger, the Grand Inquisitor. They were ordered to permanently cease any pastoral work or gay persons or their parents. Okay, now as far as I understand it, the entire speech, or whatever you want to call it, the letter released by Cardinal Ratzinger is available on the Dignity website, and you really should take a look at it if you haven't. It's unbelievable. I think this is what struck people more than they were closed down, but the language with which they used, it's medieval. It reads exactly like the Trial of Galileo.
Well, it's hate speech is basically what it is.
That's right.
I mean, they continue to use the terms intrinsically evil to describe homosexual acts, and Janine and Bob started the New Ways Ministry, we should mention.
New Ways Ministry in 1972.
Which in its day was pretty revolutionary, pretty daring, risk-taking ministry to lesbian and gay Catholics and families.
What's funny to us here is New Ways Ministry has been considered by us rather conservative as a lesbian and gay ministry.
So if they've done this to them, you can imagine what they want to do to us.
Burn, baby, burn. Okay, so
in response to this...
Yes.
Dignity snapped into action.
There we were. And on Friday, July 23rd, during another heat wave, New York and friends and parents of people in Dignity and other concerned Catholics and perhaps non-Catholics, just people with
sin,
had what we call a prayerful witness, which is sort of a small protest without causing too much trouble. But we do. This was in front of the Vatican United Nations here in New York on 9th Street. And it was really very moving.
Well, it was incredible. And to people from New York, we had folks from Long Island, from New Jersey, a lot of people, a lot of parents were very touched by seeing it. Came out 95 degrees on a Friday afternoon in July.
Yes, and they weren't in the Pines. This is where they were instead. So let's have a look at some of what went on.
And if our voice were broken, still the stones themselves would cry.
Those who would like, I don't know, there's a bit of a wind here, because we're going to have a small candle lighting ritual just before we close, to take one of the candles here and light it from the candle here, and maybe sort of in your own way, maybe commit or whatever you would wish to say before we part.
The big question is, when is the Vatican, when is Jesus going to convert the Vatican?
Amen.
Maintaining the courage and the faith and the love and even the love for our enemies, we shall overcome.
Amen.
Today reminds me that as we face a closed, old, scared, inflexible church establishment, I find strength in remembering and reminding myself that Jesus faced the same thing.
I'm very delighted to be here. My late son was very, very active in the fight for gay rights and the fight against AIDS. He succumbed about 5.5 years ago. And since then, I sort of try to do my best on his behalf and on behalf of everyone in this community. I really don't know what to say, but it's terrible. God bless you. God bless you all.
Thanks, Sonny. Well, in this latest injustice, I'm reminded of something that was said at the convention that gives consolation, is that when we look at the cross, many people contemporarily see a poor loser. But if we look with the eyes of faith, we see victory.
God doesn't make any trash. How dare a cardinal suggest otherwise?
Even though the Vatican has attempted to silence Robert Nugent and Sister Jeanine, in effect, there are many, many other voices that will take up their work. The seeds that they planted have also been reflected in teachings from the United States bishops in their writings on Always Our Children, which is similar to what Father Bob and Sister Jeanine have been teaching.
There are three things that keep me coming back, and one of them is that there are two churches, the church spiritual and the church politic, and I choose the church spiritual. The second is that we are the church, and no one can tell us any different. And the third, most important, is that God is love. God is not hate, nor does he promote hate.
I'm very glad to be here because I have great hope, because what we have heard from the Vatican and other unchristian Christians is the dying gasp of dying dinosaurs, the last gasp of dying dinosaurs. We will overcome. We will win.
Well, as you can see from that footage, it was a very moving together at Vatican Mission, a lot of personal expressions, and kudos to the members of our community, Dignity New York, Solidarity, Vigil, Prayerful, Witness, Protest, Together. We got, in response to that, a letter from Father Bob and Sister Jeanine thanking us for taking... it's a little bit too long to read on the air, but
they appreciate
suffice it
us,
to say yes. They're very appreciative of the fact that Dignity was the very first public action taken on their behalf.
Yay us!
And
however,
I have a feeling we will be back.
Not the last. Dignity National also issued a very thorough trashing of the Vatican's movement to the press, and that came out. And also, I'm really happy to report that our friends at Pax Christi, a wonderful organization dealing with all sorts of progressive and reform movements in the church, has responded very directly. Let me read this. In reaction to a Vatican ruling, that's the evil letter, Pax Christi USA urged the U.S. bishops to appeal the action. Colleen McHenry Connell, national chairwoman of Pax Christi, asked the U.S. bishops and their president, Bishop Joseph Fiorenza of Galveston, Houston, directly to appeal the Vatican decision involving Father Nugent and Sister Gramick. So we're happy to see that. I think that shows there's more, what would you call it, bridge building, yes, between gay issues and non-gay issues.
Well, it isn't all bad news on the social justice Catholic Church hierarchy front. We're happy to report that the New York Times on June 17th reported that the New York State Senate was in fact closer than ever to actually putting to a vote a hate crimes bill.
Could you plots?
That,
okay.
You know, let's just go over this. The state assembly has passed this year after year after year after year, and Governor Pataki even has said he would be happy to sign a hate crime bill if the Senate would only at least vote on it. But it seems to be moving closer than ever. In fact, Roman Catholic leaders have even expressed support for the bill. Republican officials have said that John Cardinal O'Connor appeared to be laying some groundwork for the church hierarchy to support a hate crimes bill. And let's not forget that the Cardinal on Christmas Eve abandoned his prepared remarks for midnight mass and instead spoke on the importance of hate crimes legislation and how abhorrent hate crimes are.
One of the most important developments, and I like to think Dignity has had a role in this, is that the Cardinal has made it clear that the Republican leadership in the state Senate will not be able to refer to so-called religious scruples anymore as the reason for not passing the hate crimes bill. This is huge and has a tremendous effect on other situations, other laws around the country. So let's keep our fingers crossed on that. That's a very, very positive sign. You won't read about this in the New York Times. You heard it here first, and this is what's going on.
We want to remind you the vote has not been scheduled yet, and right. We need to put all the pressure that we can on the New York State Senate. So if you live in New York, call your state senator and let him or her know that you want this voted on and you want them to support it. If you don't know who your state senator is or aren't sure how to reach them...
What's the matter with you? How can you not know?
Get with it!
Yes.
But before that, call the Empire State Pride Agenda. They will be happy to give you that information, and they can be reached at 212-627-4136. Their executive director, a former Dignity New York member, we might add.
Yes, and you may even be lucky enough to have as a state senator that wonderful Eric Schneiderman. We love you, Eric. Woof.
Welcome to New York City. In a funky cheap hotel. She managed my money. She wants to slip me a sleeping pill. She never drinks the water. Makes you order French champagne. Once you've had a taste of her.
Saturday night, and then go to the Roxy later. So that's some good stuff that's going on. And also, I understand it's time for the Dignity answer to the Council of Trent coming up.
Absolutely. Yes. The biannual Dignity USA National Convention and Meeting of the House of Delegates in Denver in August. And I will be, in fact, representing Dignity New York.
You
one of our
and
three delegates.
John Falcone and
Brendan Fay.
And Brendan Fay, of course.
Steering committee member and frequent visitor with us on the Gay Catholic Hour. So hopefully next month we'll have lots of footage and interesting stories from the Dignity...
Denver. He's confused where he's
conference.
Going. Yes. Are you taking your boyfriend?
No.
No?
No.
This ought to be a very interesting report next month, so make sure you tune in for that.
Well, that's it, folks, from the 1999 Gay Pride Day Parade. We're going to say goodbye. Remember that Dignity meets every Sunday with Mass at 7:30, followed by a social. We meet at St. John's in the Village on the corner of Waverly and West 11th Street, just west of 7th Avenue. For more information, you can call the number on the screen. So tune in next month, same time, same station. And until next time, be proud you're Catholic and be proud you're gay. Happy Gay Pride, and so long.